operator, give me the president of North Korea. If you have got an operator, a backward country like you probably doesn't even know what a telephone is. But if you do know what a telephone is and you can hear my voice, then give me the president of your country. And tell that to hurry up and speak to me on the phone, because I'm in no mood to be delayed. Understand? We are about to start a missile war on North Korea and obliterate that little swanky little country from the map. So before we do that, we'd like your consent in writing, you see. Like they say, you have the right to remain silent or to get a legal representative to offer your defense. So get that ass on the phone, right? Hello? What? Who's speaking? What do you mean, who's speaking? The ass is speaking. You wanted to talk to the ass, didn't you? The president of North Korea, the ass? Well, the ass is on the line. Now, what do you want, you bigger ass? What do you want? What? You want to know why we are threatening to attack South Korea? Well, we've got to threaten somebody, haven't we? We've got these loads and loads of missiles hanging around here in our garages and with our old Model T Ford cars thrown in the junkyards. That's all we can use them for. How long do you expect us to keep on you piling up these missiles in our garages? We've got to use them on somebody, right? So why not use them on you? You chewing gum, chewing Coca-Cola, drinking South Koreans have had it the Yankee way for a very long time. Yankee doodles? Now you doodle the Yankees. So get ready for a barrage of missiles. And I might say we have got plenty more where these came from. You know, our good old friends, the Pakistanis, have got more of them if we want them. They've got truckloads on their way right now to our capital, Seoul. Or is that your capital? Wait a minute. I'll have to get my map correct. I hope they are not sending the missiles to your capital, are they? It'll be a capital blunder. Pardon the pun. So, do you surrender? Or do we make you surrender by piling piles and piles of missiles upon you, right? You've got the option. Don't say we didn't warn you, right? And don't forget the fact that we have got Pakistan at our backs. You've got the United States of America at your back. We have got the United States of Pakistan at our back, right? Never mind if I can't speak Urdu, but that guy there understands Korean. Right? North Korean. Look here, old chap, old pal, old friend, president of North Korea. I don't want to get personal. You know, you are an ass of the first order, right? Who's better wiped off the map of the world. But all the same, let me tell you something. If you Koreans blast us Koreans with missiles and we blast you with missiles, then you know what's going to happen? No Korean will be left upon the face of the earth. That's the entire obliteration of the Korean race. How do you like that? No Koreans anywhere. All that will be left here will be Pakistanis and Americans chewing gum and Coca-Cola and a little bit of popcorn, maybe. So, my dear friend, before you start a war, just remember, do you want the obliteration of the Korean race? If you do, then obliterate yourselves. Let this half of the Korean race remain. Keep us out of the race for obliteration. Now, my dear friend, listen to me, listen to reason. You can't wipe out the Korean race just like that, right? There's got to be a more cogent reason for that than merely testing those Pakistani missiles which have got Mustafa written on them, something in Urdu. We don't want to be wiped out by missiles that carry insignias written in Urdu. We don't understand Urdu, right? How will we understand the Urdu explosions? Look. Look, there's got to be a better solution to this. You know what I think we should do? Those Pakistanis who gave you those missiles, those are the guys that should be really wiped off the face of the earth. Don't you think so? Leave us Koreans alone. You Pakis? You want to do some Paki bashing? Then do it in your own people. Don't Paki bash the Koreans. Listen to me. Friends, Koreans, countrymen, lend me your ears. Right? And mine have got wonderful hearing aids. So lending them to me will be very easy. So, listen to me, Mr. North Korean President. So you take my advice. I'll throw all my missiles on Pakistan. If you promise to throw all your missiles on Pakistan, right? And in return for that, I've got the United States of America here. They are going to give you a supply of bubble gum, popcorn, Coca-Cola, Pepsi-Cola, as well as pretzels. How's that? Shipments, millions of them. Millions of popcorns, millions of chewing gums. Millions of choco bars, milk bars. What more do you want? What? What more do you want? Look here. Maybe you've got a good point there. You're right. Maybe you're right. Why should the Korean race wipe out the Korean race? Just to give the Pakis a good wiping out show so that they can watch on their prime channel the Koreans wiping the Koreans out, right? So that they can watch on CNN, right? Maybe Al Jazeera will give them some good pictures of our Koreans being wiped out by Koreans. So what do you suggest we do? You're right. We'll return the missiles to Pakistan. How's that? And you give Pakistan more missiles as a bonus, right? Ha ha! How's that? Ha ha! Why aren't you saying ha ha? Why aren't you saying ha ha? There's something fishy about all this. Say ha ha! Then only will I agree. Say ha ha! What? I can't hear you. What? Ha ha! Okay, good. I'll repeat it for you. Ha ha! So send your missiles over to Pakistan while we send our missiles over to Pakistan. And let us obliterate Pakistan off the face of Korea. By the way, where is Pakistan? Does anybody have any idea where Pakistan is? Is it near Pipi? Well, don't mention beeping. Don't get beeping involved into all this, okay, right? It might be beeping behind our backs anyway. So, gentlemen, here's the order. You give your order, and I give my order. All missile stations, point their noses towards Pakistan. What? You don't know in which direction there is Pakistan? Find out on the Google Maps, you asses. Got it? Got the Google? Good. Point one missile at Google as well, after you wipe out Pakistan. Right? So send back all the missiles that we have taken from Pakistan back to Pakistan. And in addition, there will be a bonus coming from the South Koreans also. Right, Mr. South Korean? Your bonus will follow our bonus, won't it?
Wazir-e-Alam Sahab, where is the Prime Minister? This is Sadruddin's Riyasat, Yaqub Khan. Do you hear a funny sound in the air? It's as if lots of mosquitoes from all sides. What is this funny sound? What? You will find out from the comic channel. The comic channel may be making this funny sound to make the people of Pakistan laugh. But this doesn't appear to be a comic channel comedy. It is something else. What kind of sound? Looks like the sound is like hundreds and thousands of mosquitoes. Hundreds and thousands, millions of mosquitoes coming in our direction. What could they be? They are lighted up. Are they lighted up? What? Shall we look up in the sky? They are there. The sky is full of them. What? Are we celebrating Diwali these days? Diwali is supposed to be a Hindu festival, you fool. Nobody celebrates Diwali in Pakistan. What are they? They are all coming up. They are coming from the south. They are coming from the north. They are coming from the east. They are coming from the west. They are coming from every possible direction. What could it be? Could it be somebody just playing a joke on us? It could be possible. It could be possible. You know, lots of people have a bad sense of humor. Wait a minute. What? They look like missiles. They are missiles. They are missiles. Where are my weapons? Shoot them down. Ow. Ow. Ow.